This one's taking me a little while to get the hang of, the adding fractions using primes. So I'm going to give you another example. I write the primes of 18 above and below. So if I go to 18 and I find the primes of 18, I know it is 2 times 9. I know 3 times 3. So I write the primes above and below. Here's my primes, 2, 3, and 3, my prime factors of 18. So I've got 2 times 3 times 3. I write it above, and I write it below. And now I find my primes of 14, and I write them above, and I write them below. So I find my primes of 14, 2 times 7, and that was not very hard. So I've got 2 times 7, I write it above, and I write it below. Now my next step is to cross out any numbers that occur in all four sets. So I can see a 2, and a 2, and a 2, and a 2. That's my next step. Now the next bit beyond that is whatever's left in each of those gets multiplied by whatever number it's next to. Okay, so in this case, I've got the 4 and the 7, so I have to multiply those together. So I get 4, I might just put those brackets in, I probably should do, just to help you remember which parts are which. Right, put the brackets in, it's easier. And then I'm going to do 4 times 7. 4 times 7 is 28. And I'm left here with 5. I'll highlight what I'm left with so you can see it. 3 times 3 times 5. So I do that. I do 3 times 3 times 5. So 3 times 3 is 9, 9 times 5, 5 nines are 45. Oh, that one's tricky. 18 times 7. I didn't think that through very well when I made this one up. So I've got 18 left there and 7. So I've got 18 times 7. I better go and do a 2-digit by 1-digit over here. 18 times 7. It's okay to have working spaces. 7 eighths of 56. 7 and 5 is 12. Well done. So what's that? 126. And then over this side, I'm left with 14, 3, and 3. Oh, yeah, I didn't think that very well through. So I've got 14. Oh, dear me. I've got 14 times 3 times 3. Well, you know what? I'm going to do this bit first. 3 times 3 is 9. So I'm left with 14 times 9. So again, I'm going to use some working out over here. 4 nines are 36. 1 times 9 is 9. Plus 3 is 12. 126. So I must have done it right because I've got the same denominator. So now I'm left with these numbers here. I'm going to circle them in red. 28 over 126 and 45 over 126. So I'm left with 28 over 126 plus 45 over 126. So then it becomes a case of add 45 and 28. If you can't do that in your head, you are more than able to write it down like this. This is fine. 8 and 5 is 13. 6, 7, 73. There's nothing wrong with writing down your working 126. I actually think 73 is a prime number, so it's probably as simple as it's going to get. If it's not, let me know in the comments and we can edit it another time. Okay.